ధరణి న్యూస్ జనం కోసం నిజం కోసం సామాన్య గుంపు.
హాయ్ హలో నమస్తే వెల్కమ్ టు ధరణి న్యూస్ ఛానల్. ఈ రోజు అప్డేట్స్ చూద్దాం.
టీన్ ఆల్్రెడీ థాంక్యూ అంబాసిడర్ అంబాసిడర్ లింటర్. ఐ వాస్ జస్ట్ టెల్లింగ్ హిమ్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ దట్ He's, I meet many diplomats. I interact with several diplomats from all over the world. But I like diplomats who are not very diplomatic. So I see you as a man who speaks his mind. I see you as a man who keeps up his word. Thank you very much. You promised me a couple of months ago that you will bring in a delegation of German business groups. Thank you very much for making it happen. Karen Stoll, the Consul General, thank you, madam, for also being very, very supportive of all of our efforts. I hope for your continued guidance and continued support. BVR Mohan Reddy Garu, thank you for doing my job, sir, because I think you were very elaborate in why Hyderabad and why Telangana. Thank you very much. As always, you have been a great guide, a great friend. Thank you very much. And you know, our friends from the Indo-German Chamber of Commerce, thank you, sir, and the entire team for organizing this event. And my principal secretary, Sri Jayesh Anjan Garu, who's always spearheading, who's always been a very positive guide to many investors who continue to come and invest in Hyderabad, invest in Telangana. Thank you, Jayesh, for all your efforts. Let me start off by saying a couple of things. I think my colleague Jayesh Anjan ji was absolutely right on the money when he said there is not one India, but there is 28 Indias, which is a fact. Because a lot of times, many a times in fact, investors who are not from India, investors who are from overseas, could be Europe, it could be Americas, or it could be any other part of the world, when they start looking at India as an investment option, there is this oversimplified thinking that India is a unitary country. It is a country, but it's more like Europe. You know, it's more like Europe, where you have each country with its own culture, with its own different vibe, with its own different set of policies, etc., etc. Let me just quickly tell you why Jayesh must have said there are 28 different Indias. In India, the diversity, the heterogeneity is something that we all are amazed by, always. I mean, I'm an Indian, born and raised in India, but still I continue to be amazed with the kind of diversity that this amazing country offers. For instance, myself and Jayesh Ranjan, we both work for the same government. I'm the minister, he's the principal secretary. But the language I speak at home, my native tongue, versus what Jayesh speaks at home, are as different from each other as are German and English. That's how different India is. Everything changes in India with every 150 kilometers. The language, the culture, the dialects, the eating habits, everything is different every 150 kilometers. We have 22 official languages in India, but we have more than 300 unofficial languages also. So that's how complex, that's how diverse, that's how heterogeneous our beautiful country is. Therefore, when you are looking to invest in India, when you are looking to do business in India, please do not have an oversimplified version of India as one unit. If you engage with Telangana, you will get one version of India. If you engage with another state in India, you will get a completely different perspective of doing business in India. So therefore, my appeal to all the German investors who are looking to now redraw strategies after COVID, after the pandemic, who are looking to expand their base in India, who are looking to consolidate their position, their market share in India, my humble appeal to all of you is, you need to look beyond, you need to think beyond Delhi, you need to think beyond Mumbai. Because each state, I mean, the overall policy, the overall foreign policy, the overall trade policy, the trade agreements are decided by Government of India, but the action actually lies in the states. States is where the action really is. What do I mean? What I mean is, if you are an investor and if you are looking to invest in India, what all do you look for? Of course, a broad policy framework which enables you to bring in foreign direct investment. That's number one, which is facilitated by Government of India. What else do you look for? When you invest, we understand very well that you're not looking for the short term. You're coming into a new country, you're coming into a new territory, you're thinking long term, you're thinking of 20 years, 25 years, in some cases, maybe longer. So therefore, you need a partner. You need a partner who can actually guide you, a partner who can help you in building up, in growing together. What else would an investor need when he or she is making a business decision? You would need a few things, in my humble opinion. The first thing, of course, one would need a chunk of land to set up your factory, to set up your operations, to ensure that you actually hit the ground running. That's something Telangana, that's an area where Telangana really excels. In Telangana, we have more than 200,000 acres of land readily available for industrial usage. We have a corporation called the Telangana State Industrial Infrastructure Corporation, which will facilitate, no matter what your business requirement is in terms of land, we will facilitate that land being handed over to you, either in the form of a leasehold or in the form of a freehold piece of land, so that you can start your factory. You just heard our friends from Light Auto. They were talking about how they wanted 100 acres of land and how quick the government of Telangana was to actually come back to them within 10 days and ensure that the paperwork was all done and the MOU was signed right here, right in front of all of you. My compliments, I think, to the entire team of Light Auto for deciding to invest in the state of Telangana. Thank you very much for your investment. The second thing I would imagine you would require once you have a piece of land is clearances. So that's an area where Telangana really excels. Our Honorable Chief Minister, Shri K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, when he assumed the office of Chief Ministership about 7.5 years ago, had an extensive dialogue with the local industry, asked them a couple of questions. He sat with them for 7 hours. He said, what are all the things we need to set right? What are all the things we need to be doing, you know, to improve Telangana's attractiveness when it comes to investments? He was told 3 things. First one was, please improve the power, electricity situation in the state, because we were reeling under power outages, we were reeling under power deficiency, electricity deficiency. This was about 7.5-8 years ago. Not so anymore. Now we are a state that assures and supplies 24/7 electricity to all sectors, to industry, to agriculture, to every household. And now we also take a lot of pride in ensuring that 15% of this energy that we generate and supply comes from renewable sources, from solar and wind. We are the second largest renewable energy producing state in India today. So we are, our commitment to environment, our commitment to sustainability, our commitment to SDGs, our commitment to clean tech is something that we take a lot of pride in. Second thing he was asked was for speedy clearances, for speedy approvals. Our Honorable Chief Minister, in fact, asked Jayesh and the entire team of Industries Department to travel, to tour, and come out with the best policy possible in the country and possibly in the world. When they came back, he was not satisfied. He sent them again to visit Singapore, to visit other countries, Europe, Americas, to look at the best possible policies, industrial policies, the world. And then in November 2014, we have approved in the state legislature the Telangana State Industrial Project Approval Self-Certification System, abbreviated as the TSIPAS. Now TSIPAS is very, very unique. No other state in India has a similar policy. It's a truly, truly single window policy. Now the joke in India is every state promises a single window, but there are always multiple windows behind that one single window. But in the case of Telangana, backed by statute, backed by legislation, we do promise and deliver a truly single window system. What we promise is, if you have a piece of land approved by legislation, you can start construction of your factory on day one without any clearance, without any approval from the local government, be it the state government or the local municipality, or even the local Gram Panchayati. You can start construction of your factory on day one. You can simultaneously apply on the TSIPAS portal to the government only for regulatory purposes, because we need to know who is doing business in our state and what kind of activity they are engaged in. Once we receive your application online, we only take 15 days to deliver a yes or a no answer to you. You might say again that, you know, we've heard this before, time-bound clearances. How is Telangana different? We are different because if we do not give you a yes or a no answer in 15 days, on the 16th day, it's a deemed yes. It's a deemed automatic approval. No other state in India will tell you this. And the third thing we do, we take accountability very seriously. If we don't deliver on the 15-day window, again, by statute, by legislation, on the 16th day, the law empowers us to penalize even our bureaucracy, to penalize even our bureaucrats, to the sum of rupees 1,000 per day, till such time as they actually clear that specific application. This again, no state in India will tell you. In fact, I was in KPMG's global headquarters, talking to the chairman of KPMG, and when I explained to him this policy, and when I mentioned to him that no Indian state will offer you this, this was in New York City, our favorite city, ambassador. He looked at me, he smiled, and he said, well, no state in the United States also offers you this kind of policy. So that's how truly remarkable, that's how truly progressive the Telangana government's industrial policy is. For those of you who are thinking, who are smirking and saying, does this actually work or is this all talk? This policy has been approved in 2014, November, and we are here in December 2021. Let me tell you, we've been able to give more than 17,500 clearances so far, all in a time-bound manner in less than 15 days. And in fact, in some cases, you would be amazed, we were able to give clearances in less than 11 days, 10 days, even from 37, 38 departments. That's how efficient Telangana government's delivery has been. And, you know, as they say, what matters really is not just new investors, but existing investor sentiment also. The government of Telangana, in fact, has been able to attract several billion dollars of investment in the last 7.5 years. More than $32-33 billion of investment have come into Telangana. But what's heartening, what's extremely delightful, what makes us happy, is that 24% of that investment is actually from repeat investors who already had a base in the state of Telangana. The reason why I mention this is because as long as your existing investor is happy, they become your biggest brand ambassador across the world, because they travel, they share their success, they share their experiences with the government, with the administration, elsewhere also. So therefore, I'm delighted to tell you that this is the kind of experience the existing investors in Telangana have had in the last seven and a half years. More importantly, a couple of things we admire. In fact, when I met the ambassador and the consul general, I told both of them a couple of things I admire in Germany. And I have discussed this several times with Mr. Reddy as well. The one thing I really admire in Germany is the dual degree program that you have, where you have your students, in fact, become apprentices or interns in the industry while they're actually in a grad school. I think it's extremely important to have hands-on experience. Now, that is something I would love to emulate in Telangana. In fact, that is something we need to emulate in India if we really have to compete with the large manufacturing countries like China and United States. The second thing I really like about Germany when it comes to industry is how well and how vibrant your SME ecosystem has been. The small and medium entrepreneurs in Germany make up for the bulk of GDP that comes from the industry sector. Subject to correction, I've learned that nearly 80+% of the GDP contribution from the industry sector actually comes from the medium and the small entrepreneurs in Germany, which is a remarkable number, if you ask me, because that goes to show you how well the German ecosystem is in terms of encouraging the small and the medium entrepreneurs. And now that is something, again, I think India has a lot to learn from. That is something, again, we in Telangana certainly can take a few leaves of the view book. The more important thing that I've also learned from my experiences in meeting the German entrepreneurs Your products are of world repute. You know, all the automobiles that run on the Indian roads and elsewhere in the world are of international class, and of course, your engineering, your precision engineering, to be particular, is extremely, extremely popular. Now, Indian manufacturing sector, especially when the world is looking to move away from China, you know, either China plus one strategy or a complete exit out of China and starting to look at other avenues. I think India, in fact, we really want to take that pole position as a competitor to China. We definitely need to take a few lessons on attracting more manufacturing business to our state and other states also. And that's again where German entrepreneurs can work with us. German entrepreneurs can engage with us and help us grow this ecosystem, because we have a lot of, Mr. Mohan Reddy talked about engineering colleges. He talked about gender diversity. He talked about skilling. What I would also like to add is we have a lot of ITIs, not just IITs, but also ITIs. We also have a lot of polytechniques. We also have a lot of very, very unique vocational training institutions, which are extremely important in providing employment to different sectors of the population, different sections of the population. And especially in a manufacturing economy, all these become very, very important cogs in the wheel. So therefore, Telangana government would be very happy to also work with the German entrepreneurs and German government in ensuring that we actually create a more vibrant ecosystem with respect to manufacturing. The other thing I would also like to point out, Hyderabad and Telangana, if you look at us in the Indian map, we're bang in the middle. We're very well connected to the rest of the world. We're very well connected, of course, to the rest of the country, but we're also very, very well connected to the rest of the world. Ambassador, you mentioned Lufthansa, but I'm told by some people in Delhi that Air India would actually start services to Frankfurt and other locations, Germany, very, very soon from Hyderabad. I hope that will also help us getting more and more German entrepreneurs and German investors quickly to Hyderabad rather than come via Bombay or come via Delhi. I would also be, you know, remiss if I don't mention the current ecosystem in Hyderabad is very, very conducive. You know, we have a large number of defense labs. We have a large number of aerospace entrepreneurs. We have a large number of research labs in a variety of sectors, ranging all the way from agriculture to aerospace, as was pointed out by Mr. Reddy. Now that gives you opportunities to collaborate, to work with us across various sectors. And the last thing I would say, government of Telangana not only promises, you know, but we also deliver. We ensure speedy clearances. We ensure land allocation in a quick manner. We also ensure that whatever manpower you require, whatever human resources you require with a specific skill set, we will train them at our cost and we will offer them to you so that they are readily employable. Of course, on the locational advantages and the quality of living, Mercer is an institution that rates cities on a livability index. In the last 5 years, Hyderabad has been rated as a city with the best quality of living on the livability index in India, among all Indian cities. And also, the last thing I would say before I quit, if a German entrepreneur is willing to invest in Telangana, but is reluctant because, you know, he has a better offer in terms of fiscal incentives from another state in India, if you're willing to share that with me and Jayesh, I'll only promise you one thing. We'll either meet or beat that offer so that you make Telangana your home in the days to come. Once again, welcome you all to Hyderabad. I hope you have a fantastic stay, and thank you very much for this lovely opportunity. Cheers.
Marini, interesting news kosam chustunna undandi Dharani TV.
Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe to Dharani TV.